Hello guys, Katropa aka Big Boss Tita here, and nag-review ako ng mga crypto and NFT play-to-earn games. And we've got RiotRacers here today guys. RiotRacers is a play-to-earn car racing game where players can own parts of the game and earn Riot tokens as they play. Under siya ng Polygon at Ethereum network, so mamimili na lang kayo dyan sa dalawang network kung alin dyan ang gusto nyo na i-connect sa MetaMask ninyo. May mga free gas entry fee si RiotRacers kaya pwede tayo makalaro ng hindi gagastos. Now, nandito na tayo sa website ni RiotRacers guys, it's RiotRacers.com. Now, sa website ni RiotRacers guys, may tabs para sa marketplace, my account, learn, race, rent, at white paper. Now, punta muna tayo sa white paper guys. So friends and groupmates, andito na tayo sa RiotRacers white paper, and basically all the information about RiotRacers you can find in here. Ayan. So like I mentioned earlier guys, RiotRacers is a crypto car racing game where players own parts of the game by owning NFTs. Ano? So basically guys, players can earn rewards by playing the game or kapag meron kang NFT in the game. So, ang official in-game currency ng RiotRacers guys is the Riot token. Ayan. So, players can earn Riot tokens when winning races or by owning certain assets like gas stations or mechanic shops and by enrolling in the Riot Owners Club. Now, yung amount of Riot token na pwede mong ma-earn from racing depends sa klase ng car mo. No? So, merong 7 different classes ng cars from rookie to legendary. And medyo sanay naman na tayo sa tiers ng mga, yan, no? Of course, the higher the rarity, the higher, no? The amount that you can earn. So, Riot tokens can be spent through the game to enter races or to spawn, which is basically what they call breeding, new cars and drivers. And then, upgrade cars, buy game assets in drops, and other activities associated with the game. Now guys, when you are entering a race, pwede kang mamili ng race conditions, no? Like weather and track conditions. And players can also choose a car, no? To race with. And then meron ding ibang options na pwede mong iselect to make up your race strategy. The race then happens in the background, and results of the race are determined 20% by the driver, 29% by the car, and 51% by how well each racer's race strategy plays out. So basically guys, maraming factors na to determine yung result ng race or paano ka mananalo. So meron talaga siyang certain strategy, hindi lang siya yung basta-basta. Now, cars with higher experience and upgrades have an advantage in the rates. Ownable parts of the game include drivers, cars, car upgrades, gas stations, mechanic shops, racetrack land, and billboard land. So guys, since this is a racing game, it goes to follow na ang primary assets dito guys is the cars and drivers. So let's take a look at the cars guys, no? So basically right now guys, you can buy cars from verified RiotRacers car collection on OpenSea or during RiotRacers drops. Now, the first set of cars guys released was the Genesis. So, karamihan naman guys ng mga NFTs, yung first collection talaga nila or yung first NFTs to come out, Genesis talaga ang tawag dyan. No? So, na-release na siya nung Q2 of 2021. So, meron na ring Apollo collection, Athena collection, and Artemis collection na nalilalabas. Now guys, yung car value nyo is magde-depend upon its rarity and game attributes. So rarity guys, depende yan sa model and color ng car mo. As well as yung position and number in the release and kung anong collection siya. While yung in-game attributes guys, consists of car class, car XP, and car upgrades. So cars of course, being NFTs, can be bought and sold. And when they are sold, lahat ng upgrades naman na nailagay mo can also be purchased or also sold with the car.
Now, guys, pwede rin magkaroon ng XP points yung cars mo, no? And then, guys, may car classes din. Ito yung mga car classes na available. And it would depend on your experience point range. Now, guys, may mga car upgrades din. Since the cars are valued by their class and by their ratings, pwede mong i-level up yung sasakyan mo by purchasing upgrades. And you can actually purchase upgrades, guys, by visiting the mechanic shop section from the My Account menu. Then from there, friends, pwede na kayong mamili ng sasakyan na gusto nyong i-upgrade. And select nyo yung mga upgrades na gusto nyong i-add. Now, guys, you buy upgrades using Riot or USDC. Now, guys, upgrades are purchasable using Riot and USDC. Pero yung mga first upgrade levels, Riot lang ang pwede mong gamitin. Now, here, guys, are the upgrades available. Ayan. So, makikita nyo naman yan sa white paper. Review nyo na lang. Now, guys, meron ding car colors and groups, no? So, yung colors kasi part yan ng rarity, no? May certain colors lang na available. Although, ang colors do not affect yung racing outcome. It's more for the rarity, for the forma, which gives your car value. Now, guys, kada car may stock color na tinatawag, pero meron ding factory car class or FC na nagka-classify, no, dun sa color ng car mo. So, kung FC1 siya, mas mababa. FC2, FC3, pataas ng pataas yun, no. So, pag mas mataas, mas premium. Ayan, or mas mataas yung quality or rarity. Ayan, example ito, guys, ito. So, Dodger Blue Matte is FC1. And then, Steel Blue Metallic is FC4. So, kung pansin nyo dito, mas premium yung color nitong si FC4. Ayan, ganyan. Now, guys, may car rarity resources din na tinatawag. So, ito yung Genesis car model info sheet. You will find this in the white paper. You can go ahead and review and check, no? Basically, kung ano yung model rarity ninyo or ano yung variable rarity ninyo. So, katulad nga na nabanggit ko kanina, guys, you can actually purchase RiotRacers cars on OpenSea. So, just go to OpenSea and makikita nyo yung RiotRacer car collections and you can actually buy from there. So, right now, guys, yung pinaka floor price ng RiotRacers, so yung pinaka mura sa OpenSea is nasa 0.009 Ethereum, which is roughly around $14 or mga 900 plus pesos dito, no? Pero most likely, guys, that is the lowest rarity, no? Pero it's not bad, no? Kung gusto mo bumili talaga ng NFT, you can do so, and yun yung floor price niya. But if wala ka namang budget, you can actually also rent, no, dito sa RiotRacers. And yun ang maganda dito, kasi you can rent kung wala kang enough budget to buy an NFT. And mamaya, papakita ko sa inyo yan, makikita niyo yan mamaya. Yung isang napaka-importanting element pa that you have to have here in RiotRacers is yung drivers. So, of course, kailangan may mag-drive nung car mo. So, drivers are ranked by winning percentage, earnings, and races completed. Now, guys, 20% ng outcome ng race mo nakadepende sa driver mo. And drivers actually have traits, no? So, aside from the fact na pwede ka mamili ng male, female, and even mecha, no, na driver kung gusto mo, drivers also have a variety of visual characteristics katulad na lang ng facial expressions, hair, hats, clothing, and iba pa. So, all of these attributes, guys, nakaka-contribute sa rarity ng bawat driver. Now, there are 4 types of drivers also, guys, no? Earth, wind, fire, and water. Now, each type of driver will be better suited for specific race conditions. And ang most rare, guys, is actually fire, then wind, then water, and then yung least rare is yung earth type na driver. Now, guys, kada driver may varying levels din ng speed, braking, handling, endurance, and vision. And yung value range ng each trait is between 50 and 100. And syempre, pag mas mataas yung values na yon or specific traits na yon ng isang driver, mas malaki yung advantage niya, especially in certain race conditions. So currently, guys, no, merong Genesis Drivers Collection. And you can also buy this on OpenSea. Ayan. So right now, guys, yung pinakamurang driver floor price is around 0.005. Now, guys, dito sa RiotRacers is actually pwede ka rin mag-breed. Ang tawag nila dito is spawning. So, spawning is the creation of new RiotRacer game assets. And cars and drivers can actually spawn offspring. Ayan, so all the other details about spawning is here in the white paper, guys. Yan, basahin nyo na lang yan. And now, guys, let's talk about some of the sustainability measures na meron naman tong si RiotRacers, guys, no? So, first of all, guys, there is stamina. So, di naman na tayo bago dito. Basically, stamina is the number of times na pwede mong laruin, no? Yung game asset mo in a play to... Basically, stamina, guys, is the number... Basically, stamina, guys, is the number of times, no, a game asset can participate in play-to-earn races in a 24-hour period. So, each race, guys, will utilize one stamina, and kapag umabot na zero yung stamina mo, di ka na pwedeng mag-participate in any play-to-earn races until makarecover ka ng stamina. So, cars and drivers will regenerate stamina each hour and will range from 1 to 1.5 stamina per hour depending on the collection to which the car driver belongs to. Now, may cooldown periods din dito, guys. Every time a new game asset is spawned, magkakaroon ng cooldown period. Pareho yung parent and yung newly spawned offspring will have a cooldown period that varies in duration based on their collection. And these cooldown periods will limit both spawning and racing activities. As for time to retire or TTR, self-explanatory na yan, guys. Hindi mo na magagamit yung game asset mo, whether it's car or driver, once umabot na siya sa status na to. Now, the idea behind the TTR, guys, is to protect against market oversupply and maintain stability in the RiotRacers play-to-earn ecosystem, which ultimately benefits everyone, yeah. So, alam naman natin, guys, no, just to compare it with one of the most popular play-to-earn games with Axie Infinity, yun yung naging problema, no? So, overbreeding, overpopulation, and then only use pa yung NFTs. So basically, guys, that caused, no, the Axie market to crash. So with RiotRacers, they're hoping to prevent that by inputting this TTR or time to retire, which I think is very good, no, sustainability wise. As for other ownable game assets, guys, meron din silang gas stations, which is actually the most rare land asset here in RiotRacers because there are only 20 gas stations, no, in the Genesis collection of game assets. So here in RiotRacers, guys, yung gas actually functions as the entrance fee for racers. So every time na mag-enter ng race ang isang car, racers first stop at a gas station and buy fuel. And of course, guys, owning itong mga land assets na to will give you certain benefits. Mainly, guys, you can earn Riot tokens, no? So, the more rare your land asset is, the more rewards you can get. Then, guys, there are mechanic shops where racers, no, bring their cars to buy and install upgrades. And there are only 75 mechanic shops in the Genesis collection. Ayan. So, obviously, you can also earn Riot tokens by owning a mechanic shop. Plus, you get a 15% discount, no, on all upgrades for your own cars. Then, guys, there's the racetrack land where cars can race on designated racetracks based on a car's racing class. And yung billboard land naman, guys, you can place ads directly in the game dynamically. You can place your own ads or sell ads to others and place it for them. Now, guys, if you don't have a car or driver NFT yet, like wala ka pang budget for it, you can actually rent, no, a car and a driver. And best of all, guys, it is actually free. So this is actually where you can rent a car and a driver.
So guys, let's go ahead and try out the game na. So all you need to do, guys, is to connect your MetaMask account, no, or your MetaMask wallet to RiotRacers. Just make sure, guys, na nasa tamang website kayo. So that's RiotRacers.com. Ayan. Once makapasok naman kayo, guys, makikita nyo yung wallet nyo dito sa part na to. And dito naman yung activity logs mo. Dito sa left side naman, makikita natin ang mga tabs ng overview, my profile, drivers, garage, breeding, assets, rewards, team, wallet, at settings. So overview, dito nakalagay yung mga owned cars mo. So currently, guys, wala akong owned car, but nag-rent tayo and mamaya papakita ko yan. Dito naman sa my profile, naka-indicate dyan is ang username at ang wallet plus yung mga NFTs natin dito sa RiotRacers. Dito naman tayo sa drivers tab, guys. May dalawang tabs dito, owned at rented. Kung meron kayong na-rent na drivers, guys, yan, dyan siya lalabas. So, guys, like I mentioned, nag-rent nga ako dito. So, yan, yan yung nakikita nyo sa screen. So, may 4 drivers tayo, guys, which is wind, water, earth, at fire, na sabi ko nga kanina. And pinakamataas na rarity, guys, is yung fire. Then, yung wind, water, at yung pinakamababa is earth. So, bawat drivers, guys, may mga traits like speed, braking, handling, endurance, vision, at stamina. And bawat driver may kanya-kanyang winning percentage. Depende pa rin sa discarte nyo, guys, kung anong ipapartner yung mga drivers at mga cars na meron kayo. So, very strategic pa rin tong game na to, no? Talagang naka-anchor pa rin sa strategy. So, pumunta naman tayo sa garage, guys. Dito makakita ang mga owned at rented cars natin. So, just like with the drivers, guys, ang cars ay may stamina rin. And nababawasan yan kada race ninyo. So, of course, guys, may iba't ibang klase ding classes ng cars dito sa RiotRacers. At ito nga ang Rookie, Rally, Driver, Tracker, Aero, Pro, at Legendary. And of course, from the word itself, Legendary, guys, of course, yan yung pinakamataas na klase. Naka-indicate din dyan, guys, yung mga winning percentage ng bawat car. Pero of course, depende pa rin sa diskarte natin para manalo tayo. So, let's go ahead and start a game and play, guys. Click lang ang race tab na nasa taas, then click ang driver tab. So, try muna natin yung rookie car, guys, no? So, kiklik lang natin yung rookie tab if we have a rookie car. Then, check nyo lagi, guys, yung part na to before kayo sumali sa race. Yung car class na meron kayo and yung gas fee. So, pag nakita nyo yan, guys, it means wala tayong babayaran pagsasali tayo sa mga races. But of course, kapag free ang entry, mas mababa rin ang makukuha natin na Riot tokens as compared to kung magbabayad tayo. Which is actually almost double yung pwede natin makuhang Riot token pag ganun. So, bago tayo makapag-start ng race, guys, kailangan muna natin i-complete yung captcha. This is to ensure, guys, no, na walang bot players. So, maganda yan actually for the game. So, ito na, guys, pipilin tayo ng driver. And guys, kapag rookie car yung gamit mo, any driver type is pwede naman sa kanya. And guys, remember na may time limit, no, sa pag-setup ng driver and car and sa pagpili. So, just be wary or be aware lang, no, dun sa time limit na yon. Now, piliin natin muna ang win na driver, guys. And next, yung car naman. Since rookie ang pinili natin, rookie car automatic ang lalabas dito. Ayan, so nakikita natin, guys, yung rookie car natin. Se-select lang natin yan. Then, sa strategy, guys, you can choose yung strategy nyo. May default nang nakalagay, pero nasa sa inyo pa rin kung gusto nyo yung palitan. So, remember, guys, na nasa discarte nyo pa rin or strategy nyo pa rin kung paano kayo mananalo, no? Kaya, you have to choose wisely, ayan. So, this game, RiotRacers, is still very strategic siya, guys. Dito palo-palo lang. Kailangan pinag-iisipan nyo pa rin yung gagawin nyo. Ayan, so nakapili na tayo ng strategy na gagamitin natin. Try lang muna natin yung ganyang combination. Ayan, so click natin yung enter race na para makapag-start na once nakapili na tayo ng strategy natin. Ayan, so successful ang pag-join natin sa race. I-check natin sa view pending races button yung race natin. So ongoing pa rin yung race na sinalihan natin, guys. I-check na natin sa results tab kung meron na. So, may result na yung race natin kanina, guys, no? So, second placer tayo. Ibig sabihin, maganda yung strategy na combination na napili natin. So, ito naman ang result details, guys, about the race na sinalihan natin. So, like I mentioned kanina, second place ang nakuha natin. Then, dito natin makikita din yung ginamit nating car and also yung driver natin, which is yung wind driver nga and rookie na car. Then, yung strategy combination, guys, na ginamit natin, makikita din natin dito and pwede natin i-save yan, guys, para magamit pa natin sa mga susunod pa natin na races. And hindi na natin kailangan piliin pa isa-isa if we save it. Now, as a second placer sa rookie division ng RiotRacers, guys, we've got 2.580 Riot token. Yun ang nakuha natin sa race na yan. Now, check natin, guys, sa CoinGecko kung magkano ang conversion. So, currently, guys, ang isang Riot token ay nagkakahalaga ng 4 pesos and 30 centavos. Ayan. So, kung i-convert natin yung 2.5 Riot na nakuha natin, that would be 11.094 pesos. So guys, actually that's not bad, no, kasi yan yung pinakamababang division and nakakaisang race pa lang tayo. So mas maraming race tayong masasalihan, mas maganda para mas mataas yung profit natin. And of course guys, dahil nga nakadepende sa number of races na magagawa natin yung earnings natin, kung mas marami kang cars and mas marami kang drivers, mas malaki yung pwede mong ma-earn. So let's try joining again guys. Click natin yung race and mag-try ulit tayo ng rookie race. Ayan. So itong first race ay may 2 drivers na guys. Free ang gas entry fee and ang prize pool ay 8.6 Riot tokens. So pwede tayong sumali dito guys. Gawin lang natin ulit yung captcha as like before. And then makikita natin puno na yung race. Ibig sabihin may mas naunang nakapasok na player. So pag ganyan guys, balik lang tayo sa race tab sa taas. Then choose naman natin ang pro. Ayan, try na natin ang pro guys. So same thing, gawin lang natin ang captcha. Then pili ulit tayo ng driver guys. So piliin na ulit natin si Wind. Tapos this time guys, yung car naman natin ay pro. Ayan, so ito yung pro car natin guys. So dahil pro yung pinili nating division, automatic yung pro na car ang makikita natin. So pili rin tayo ng strategy natin guys. It's the same thing as we did before sa rookie. Pipiliin natin yung strategy na gusto natin. So like I mentioned earlier guys, nakadepende talaga dito sa strategy ang pagkakapanalan ng driver and ng car mo. And once nakapili na tayo, click lang natin yung enter race. So successful na ulit yung pagsali natin sa race guys. And then punta lang tayo sa pending races tab. So wala na siya dito, it means tapos na yung race. Ayan, so punta tayo sa results tab guys. So ayan, may results na. I-click lang natin para makita natin ang details ng results. Ayan. So this time guys, second place ulit tayo sa pro division. Nabawasan ng 1 stamina ang driver at ang car natin this time guys. And then nakakuha naman tayo ng 4.260 Riot token. So as you noticed guys, sa pro division times 2 ng nakuha natin sa rookie division. So i-save lang natin ang strategy na ito dahil naka-second naman tayo. It's not bad, no? Kung gusto nating i-keep na yung strategy na ito para hindi tayo paulit-ulit nag-e-enter kapag every time we enter a new race. Ayan. So lagay nyo lang yung name ng strategy na para madali nyo maalala. Ayan. Then save na yan. So check naman natin ang wallet natin guys. So dun sa unang race na nilaro natin, like I mentioned, nakakuha tayo ng 2.68 Riot tokens or nasa 0.17 USD. Sa isang race pa lang yan guys. So it's really not bad. Lalo na kung araw-araw mo siyang lalaruin. Napakasimple lang naman ng laro na to guys. Nasa strategy mo na lang kung paano ka talaga mananalo and mamamaximize mo yung earnings mo dito. So may 7 races tayong nasalihan guys. So sa 7 races na yan guys, less than 30 minutes lang yung in-spend ko dyan, so not bad na rin.
Now that you've seen how to play the game guys, discuss naman natin tong Riot token. So yung Riot token guys is the native game currency that powers the RiotRacers metaverse. And that includes the RiotRacers game guys, as well as yung mga upcoming games pa nila like the Riot Rampage and Riot Rush. The Riot game token guys allows players to earn rewards in games, buy game assets, pay for actions in games, claim rewards, and participate in governance. Ayan. So ito lahat yung mga uses no guys ng Riot token. Now friends and groupmates, like I always tell you, for anything na crypto related no, even if I am already reviewing a certain play to earn game or NFT or kung ano mang crypto project yan, it is best pa rin no, na bago nyo pasukin is you do your own research no, kasi mas maganda guys na yung decision manggagaling talaga sa inyo at sa na-research nyo ng sarili. Kasi sa iba't ibang sources guys, may mapupulot kayo na iba, no? So mas maganda kung alam nyo lahat ng information. And the best way for you to do that guys is to go to their website, which is riotracers.com, no? You can also check their social media accounts, no? So to get yourselves updated with anything about RiotRacers and to do for you to get more information, no? Para you can make an informed decision. Now guys, one of the most important documentation that will help you not to really understand RiotRacers is their white paper. So that's whitepaper.riotracers.com sabi ko nga kanina, lahat ng information makikita nyo dyan. So, you read up on it, make sure you understand, no, na what RiotRacers is about. But, this is very engaging, no. Maganda siyang game that I think people will enjoy. And sa play to earn aspect naman niya, guys, may sustainability options naman siya or may sustainability plans siya. So, now, if medyo naguguluhan pa kayo sa white paper no, on how to start the game, they actually also have a quick start guide. Just go to quickstart.riotracers.com and then just go through the quick start guide. And then, there's also strategy tips, guys, no, lalo na kung beginner ka pa lang.
So that's it for today's video, friends and groupmates. Hope to see you again next time. And remember, friends, always do your own research and only risk what you can afford to lose. Until next video, bye-bye.
Go, go, go!